actually shone on the catwalks of Europe, smouldered on the big screen, and is a titan of swimwear. Plus, she dished up advice on reality TV, and now she says her greatest job is being a mum. Please welcome to the show supermodel Megan Gale.
Good morning. Great to see you guys.
Do you have two young children and look like you do, so polished and perfect and well put together?
I don't roll out of bed like this. You realise that, right? There's an army of people that do a little bit of spit and polish and get me scrubbed up. No, I absolutely, and this is not, I'm not being mum right now, obviously. It's usually like dirty hair, messy top knot. Yes, it's not always glamorous.
That gives us hope.
Okay. That's okay. You don't have to be glamorous. Your kids don't judge you.
You have these two beautiful children.
Which I love.
Rosie's 19 months now.
Almost 20 months.
Wow.
I know. It flies, doesn't it?
It does.
Has she hit the terrible twos yet? Is she doing the whole...
She hit it. When she came out, she was just like a force to be reckoned with, which I love. I love that I've got this little girl that is just, she's fearless and she's fierce and she's resilient and she knows what she wants, and it's very hard with it when that's in toddler form, but I think that's going to serve her well later in life.
You need to raise young girls to be brave, I think.
She's doing it by herself. She's her own force. I love it.
What I noticed after...
She's actually watching right now. Hello, sweetheart. Hi, Rosie. She's with her Nana D. Hi, guys.
What I noticed after you had Rosie, that you kind of went quiet, especially on social media. You tend you pulled back. What was the reason behind that?
I was driving a startup business, and anyone who's done that whilst trying to be a very present mum and working from home, and I just literally I didn't have the time to do it. I was so focused on what I was doing, and I sort of and there wasn't really much for me to document because I was being mum, I was working on this business, and that was it.
You're in the trenches.
I was in the trenches, and the trenches. Mm. There's merit for being in the trenches, but the trenches aren't necessarily that fun to look at. They're not. But it was good. It was good to give myself that headspace to focus on what was important.
I was going to say, there were two dads I spoke to years ago before I had kids. And one, and they had very high powerful roles. One was a newspaper editor, the other ran a newspaper company.
Right.
And they just said to each other, once they've had their first kids, they said, I just don't care about anything else anymore.
Yep.
I just don't care about the like this job that was once my whole life.
Yep.
Suddenly,
perspective.
Was it like that with you? It's like 100%. Suddenly all the fame,
really?
All the trappings just 100%. Go out the window.
100%. I mean, I felt like I had a pretty, you know, good head on my shoulders in terms of how I viewed my industry and work and all of that. But I think when you have kids, but there were still things that bugged me and got me riled up and got me. You know, my feelings got hurt with certain things, and I got very sensitive about things. But then when you have kids, you kind of just go, oh, that doesn't matter.
Mm. Yeah.
It really doesn't matter. Yeah. And the beautiful thing about children is they kind of, they're so present, little kids, and they kind of remind you about being present, and they remind you to come into their world and just how simple life can be and how easy it is.
Yeah.
It really does.
But going back 5 years, when you were pregnant, I think it was with River. You were very sick.
With River, wasn't so much I was sick. With River, I wasn't too bad. With Rosie, I was very sick. Mm. And I broke my foot at 15 weeks. So I was in a moon boot for a month.
Oh,
and then when I got my moon boot off, I got food poisoning. And I was actually talking to someone about this morning, and I had to go to hospital and put me on a drip because I was just constantly vomiting. It was horrible. So I didn't have a very good pregnancy with her. With River, though, it was pretty good. But yeah, I think at the end of the day, you know, pregnancy can be quite tough. But if you get some beautiful, healthy children at the end of it, it's all that really matters, isn't it?
Worth it. Was there a time with everything as busy as you were? Because I remember when you were doing, I just saw a couple of dresses on the overlay there. I was there at those occasions when you came out.
You sure were.
Jones print.
Yeah.
You're doing Australia's Next Top Model. You were travelling all over the place.
Yeah.
Every ball was in the air.
Yep.
Did you see a point where you had to say, whoa?
Yeah.
I've taken on too much,
absolutely.
And did that sort of start an idea in your head?
It kind of, I guess I'd already had the idea to do this new business, but I think what having that kind of mouse on a wheel mentality for someone that was in their head a lot, and the nature of my business, and not different to what you guys do, it's always deadlines and go and jump on a plane and travel and we've got to get the shot and you've got to change your outfit and you've got to get on the catwalk and it's all rush, rush, rush. And there's not much, you know, there's that show that goes on mentality with the entertainment industry, and there's not really much space for saying no and saying, I need to stop. Because you've got to seize your moment. Because
that's right. You never know where the next job's coming from.
You've got to ride the wave and all of that. But then when your health starts to suffer, which mine did, and then it's not about you anymore when you're a parent. You've got to be there for your kids. You have to stop and reassess, or at least personally I did. And that kind of became, I guess, a little bit of an underlying message for this brand as in terms of being more wellness and health style, lifestyle and health and wellness, and reminding us that it's okay to say no. It's okay to stop, reconnect and recharge yourself.
So what is that brand? What did that lead you to?
That became, I guess, the foundation for Mindful Life. So I started off developing these, you know, really beautiful, safe, gentle products for children and babies, but then I didn't want it just to be product-driven. I didn't want to just churn out some products and make a buck. It had to have a bigger purpose and a bigger message that would hopefully help people. And that's where it came back to mindfulness, which is something that my mum has always tried to instill in me. I'm not great at it. Again, I'm that mouse on a wheel girl. It's hard, but it's not all, you know, just this hippie woo thing. It's just really about being present and connected with yourself, with your kids, checking in. And just coming back to that, whether it's 5 minutes a day or an hour a day.
Speaking of being connected, there was a time, and this is all I care about, the rest has just been a ruse, where you were going to be connected to a golden lariat.
Yes.
10 years ago, you were going to be Wonder Woman.
And you were going to more than 10 years ago.
Awesome.
It was like 12 years ago now.
That's not possible,
I know. There
you're
I
only
am.
19.
Oh, you found the pictures. This, like, which were, they were kind of unearthed. They were not really meant to
no,
be
No, I know, but by God, they went around the world in a second.
Test.
George Miller was going to make it.
It was all going to happen. It could have been amazing.
So
it could have been amazing.
What happened? That was a large part of the reason why I stepped off the catwalk for David Jones, because they wanted to. Warner Brothers wanted to sign me for a three-picture deal.
Yeah.
With to do the Justice League films, and then also options to do Wonder Woman movies. So of course I was like, of course, I'm not going to say no to that. Yeah. And I felt like at the same time my time with David Jones was kind of not over, but the catwalk thing, I mean, I'd done so many shows at that point and I felt like I was time to step into something else. And so I signed on and then several things happened. There was this, you know, the famous writer strike that happened in 2008, February 2008. So we couldn't keep developing the script and the characters because they went on strike. And then also there ended up being some issues with Christopher Nolan had the rights to the Batman franchise, and then we had a different Batman who was Armie Hammer playing Batman, so there was a conflict there, and that had all just got shelved.
But you are still Wonder Woman though, juggling two young kids.
Do you know
career,
what's really weird? My son has superheroes, and I gave him one of my Wonder Woman figurines that I got given from Warner Brothers, and he doesn't know about the Wonder Woman thing, and neither does Rosie, and they both picked it up and went, look, it's Mama.
How
bizarre is that?
But do you still have the costume?
I never got to have that. No, I think that's sitting in New Zealand somewhere, or I don't know. I know. That would have been fun for dress-ups, but it only fits me.
It could have changed the course of the DC movie universe, because a lot of people have been really disappointed with it. You could have saved the entire DC universe.
I think Gal Gadot, though, she's done an amazing... I think she was very well received.
Gal's great, she's good
as Wonder Woman, and I think, I was happy when she was cast because I thought, well...
Who was going to play Superman? Was that when Nicolas Cage was...
An actor called DJ Catrona was going to play Superman. George had very, he wanted to find people that weren't overly well-known.
Yeah.
And he wanted them to have just a bit of an edge. So DJ had like tattoos and like he was really exotic looking kind of guy. It was a very different kind of Superman that was going to be.
George cast you in Mad Max Fury Road.
Yeah. He did.
I forgot to give you a costume.
he threw that on me after I signed on. How do you feel about being nude? And I was like, George, really? He's like, we're not going to be in here, and you'll have a, G-string on and we can take it out later. I was like, okay. And that's why I had the long hair because I wanted it to cover my boobs. I wanted some bit of modesty, but it was so windy on the day. And I'm trying to, like, get Hollywood tape and stick down my hair. It didn't work and I was like, bugger it, let's just go for it.
Oh.
I know, it was a great experience, though. My God.
Yeah, you are absolutely delightful. Megan's new skincare range is The Mindful Life. You can head to themindfullife.com.
Yeah.
For all the product range. Thanks for dropping by.
Thanks, guys.